I do, but if I do, then I'm sorry. I'm like I said, I'm not the best singer in the world. I'm, in fact, I'm not even a good singer. But I really just want to do this for God, and He told me to do it. So I'm just trying to be obedient to Him. But I've been working on one for a while, and so just wasn't quite working out. So I started another one a couple of nights ago, and it just has worked out. So you know, there's a reason for it. I don't know what it is. Maybe it's for somebody out there. Maybe it's for me. You know, but I'm just trying to be obedient to Him. The name of the song is "My Hero." You know, Tristan calls me his hero. We all have heroes out there. I'm a big Superman fan, which I wore this shirt just to kind of prove a point. But you know, I'm my son's hero, and Superman is a fictional hero, and we're all looking for a hero. But you know, there's one out there that's a hero to us all, and it should be and could be a hero to us all, and that's Jesus. You know, He came here on earth 2,000 years ago to die on a cross, and take our sins on the world for us, so that we could have the opportunity to have eternal life and live with Him. And you know, and I may be my son's hero, but I'm going to die one day. I mean, providing the Lord don't come back and rapture me out, I'm going to die one day. And Superman is a fictional hero. He's not real, you know, but, you know, Jesus is a real hero, and He's still alive. He did die. He died on that cross 2,000 years ago, but on the third day, He rose again. I just want to read a couple of scriptures from Luke. Chapter 19, verse 10 says, "For the Son of Man is come to seek and to save that which was lost." You know, and that's why He came, to seek us out. You know, this song is, I guess it's just, you know, kind of how I felt in my soul. And you know, I think a lot of us feel that way. And we all have a void in our soul that only God and only Jesus can fill. You know, we're all missing something until you find Him, because He's the only thing that can fill that void. You know, we can fill it with drugs, and we can fill it with alcohol and any other types of sin that there is, but it's only pleasurable for a season. And, you know, I've been doing a lot of thinking and praying about that. And, you know, it only gets you so far. And, you know, I mean, and sin will ruin your life. It really will. But there's, you know, there's other things out there that come in between you and God, and that you try to fill that void with, and something fun and pleasurable. But like I said, it's only pleasurable for a season. In reality, the only thing that can fill that void is Jesus. And you know, I wanted to read a pretty popular scripture just real quick, but it said, "For God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in Him should not perish but have everlasting life. For God sent not His Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through Him might be saved." And you know, I mean, and I know that's a popular verse, and everybody knows it. And if you don't know it, it's pretty powerful verse, and we've all heard it since we were kids. But you know, that's why He came. He sent His Son here to die on a cross for us, so we could have the opportunity to live with Him. So I you know, something I was going to say was Sunday, which was yesterday, Pastor was preaching on believing on and believing in, and the difference between it. And I didn't get a chance to tell you. So Pastor Rob, if you're watching, I didn't get a chance to tell you after church, but you were preaching, and you started talking about believing in and believing on, and I was really actually having trouble getting the difference. You know, I was thinking, what is the difference? And then you gave this scenario of the man on the tightrope. So if y'all get a chance, watch that on I'm sure it's on Facebook from World Outreach Ministries. But you started talking about that, and I mean, it was like immediately those thoughts were popping into my head, like, well, what's the difference? And then you explained the difference, and then I thought, well, what's his thoughts on John 3:16, because, you know, he said that whosoever believeth in him, and then you explained that, and it was kind of like, I thought that, and then you said it, and watch that message. It was a really good message, and really powerful, and really, really touched me, so I was thankful for it, but, yeah, I want to try this. I wanted to say too, I've been working with the dad bought a GoPro, and so I've been having some fun with it and filming. I've been out mushroom hunting a lot this year, and out metal detecting and stuff. And so I've been posting some videos on YouTube with that too, just for fun, you know. I mean, I don't want to do this to get famous. I just, you know, I'm hoping that, you know, people, you know, see the joy of my heart, because I say a lot about God in those, or I feel like I do, or I try to, and, you know, so I'm hoping people can see the joy in my heart that God gives me, and I'm very, very thankful for that. But I was thinking about my YouTube channel just as Aaron Jeffers now, but I was talking to Mom about it, and I think I'm actually going to change the name and actually title it and put Fishers of Men Adventures and Ministries, because this is my ministry, and I want to, you know, put it out there, and, you know, because I just want people to see what God can do in your life, and what he can bless you with. So if you think that's a good name, let me know. If not, you know, I don't know, send me a message on Facebook or something. But sorry to talk so long, but I think I want to change the name of it to that. So I hope that's a good one. So I want to try my hand at this song, and working on editing and stuff, so maybe if I mess this one up really bad, then I can I'll edit it a little bit. But let's give it a shot. Thank you. he made me whole. So I hope you enjoyed that. Hope you got something from it. I enjoyed it. I enjoyed the song. Like I said, I'm a big, I love Superman. I love heroes. I love the thought of it. But you know, it's really cool to have a living hero that we have, especially when he lives inside of you and fills that void. And any chain that you have and anything that's holding you down and making you feel lost and that darkness in your soul and you just don't feel right, God can take care of it. God can take care of anything, you know. I was praying for my little boy in there. He's sick. And, you know, say a prayer for him. You know, it's just allergies and a cold. And my wife is too. They've got it both. But, you know, those little things that, like that, sometimes I think, you know, that's not important to God, but it is. Everything's important to God, you know. He knows how many hairs are on the top of our head, whether or not how short and scraggly they may be, but he knows everything about us. He knows our hearts. He knows our soul. He knows what we need. He knows what you need. So if you have that darkness and that void, and you know, there's chains and shackles that are holding you down, God can take care of them, and he can take care of you. If you don't know him, you know, all it is a simple prayer and simple belief that just, you know, say, God, I believe in you. I believe on you, Pastor Rob. I believe you came to this earth 2,000 years ago, and I believe you died on a cross for our sins, and I believe that you rose on the third day, and I believe on you, and I put all my trust and all my hope in you. I'm in the wheelbarrow, Pastor Rob. Watch that message. I'm in the wheelbarrow, and you've got control of it. And according to God's word, I am saved. And that's all it is. Dig into the Bible. Message me. Ask me if you have any questions or any needs or just want me to pray for you. I'd be glad to. So God bless you all. thanks for listening. Hope it didn't sound too bad for you. So I don't claim to be the best singer. I don't claim to be a good singer, but I do it for God and trying to be obedient to Him. So thanks, guys. God bless.